everyone, welcome to Hada Labo's Be Skin Smart Time. I'm your host Chloe, a blogger, and here with me is Valerie, our skincare expert for the show. In every episode, we'll be talking about the various topics on skincare, followed by a demo segment, and lastly a Q&A segment. Log on to our Hada Labo's Facebook SG page and vote for the questions regarding skincare that you are dying to get your answers to. Else, you could always key in your questions and await our answers. So now let's get ready to further understand our skin even better. Hey Valerie, I noticed a trend in Singapore's skincare products and brands, predominantly more from the West, like US and France, and from the East, Japan and Korea. Is there really a difference in Asian and Caucasian skin?
Well, for starters, the skin has got three layers. The top epidermis, middle dermis, and the bottom hypodermis. Asian skin has thinner stratum corneum, which is the outermost layer of the epidermis skin. So this means Asian skin has weaker skin barriers, tend to be more sensitive, and hence scars more easily.
That's not fair!
I know, and that's not all. Asian skin also has more compact epidermis, which means it loses water more easily with a higher tendency to dehydrate. Asian skin also absorbs skincare products at a slower rate, making penetration of skincare products more difficult.
Oh! Gosh, I want to ask you about dehydration later, but we'll first talk about the sun. How is our reaction of our skin to the sun?
Well, Asian skin produces more melanin, so we have more issues with hyperpigmentation. We do get tan more easily, but the good thing is we do not get burnt as easily. Asian skin also has more sebaceous glands, which makes our skin oilier. So when Asian skin is not hydrated well, it produces more oil. This also means Asian skin requires regular exfoliation.
So after hearing all that, is there any good to our Asian skin?
There is. Asian skin is actually more resistant to aging. It has got thicker, denser middle dermis layer with a high concentration of collagen. So the main priority need for Asian skin is hydration. That's why the Japanese women who generally have lovely skin, they are obsessed about hydration. Because they know skin inside for a long, long while. And Korean brands subsequently took the cue from the more established Japanese brands.
So I see. Everyone, that's the secret. So, Caucasian skin and Asian skin are so different, I assume that their skincare approach will be different as well?
Yup, that's right. Asian brands such as the Japanese brand or even TCM brands, they work differently from the European brands. They work from the innermost layer up to the outermost layer. So Japanese brand Hada Labo works on Asian skin from within using the Super Hyaluronic Acid Hydrating Lotion immediately after cleansing for deep penetration. This approach works on the idea of skin regeneration. By doing this, we allow good cell renewal, and this translates to the radiance of skin from within. Now, this approach works for all skin types and on top of any specific skin concerns.
So, with all this different skincare approach, does it mean that our daily skincare routine differ as well?
Yes, with classical skincare approach, you take care of the outer skin and then you treat the inner skin based on specific skin concerns. So the basic skincare routine will consist of three products: a cleanser, a traditional wipe-away toner which can strip away skin's own water, and then moisturizer. Now, the basic skincare approach for Japanese brands, as I said earlier, it works from within. So the basic skincare routine is different. After step one of using the cleanser, we use lotion as Asian skin needs more hydration, and then we moisturize.
So it sounds like Asian brands really understand Asian skin the best.
Yes, especially Japanese brands, since they are the pioneers in skincare development and they have been developing products for years. Hada Labo is developed by Mentholatum and Roto Pharmaceuticals in Japan. It understands Oriental Asian skin structure and physiology best and appreciates the beauty of clean, beautiful skin without any makeup.
So, do you want to know how to achieve beautiful skin with Hada Labo's perfect and simple skincare approach? Then stay tuned for our next segment as we demonstrate the correct application techniques to get the most out of your regimen. Be right back!
For the first demonstration, let's learn the day and night application for the Super HA Hydrating Lotion. For the day application, step 1, pour 2 to 3 drops of Super HA Hydrating Lotion. Step 2, pat on cheek with whole palm using gentle pressure. This is to pat the hydrating ingredients into Asian compact skin to promote penetration and activate the skin's absorption power. Then move towards the nose and forehead and chin, and finally the neck.
Finally, complete with moisturizer and UV block or layer essence after lotion before moisturizer if your skin needs it. Your skin is ready to face the day. For the night application of the Super HA Hydrating Lotion, there's just one more little step to take advantage of skin's regeneration at night. Step 3, repeat the same for the day application, followed by finger tapping over face. First, the cheek area. This helps to stimulate blood circulation and enhance skin's absorption. Moving to the forehead area. And finally, the chin and neck areas. And finally, complete with moisturizer or layer essence after lotion before moisturizer if your skin needs it. This will take your skin comfortably through the night. Isn't this simple and easy? Next, we are going to demonstrate using the Super HA Hydrating Lotion application with cotton pad as additional use for double cleansing after face wash. This usage can be the same for both day and night, replacing the traditional wipe-off toner. Step 1. Soak cotton wool with Super HA Hydrating Lotion. Step 2. Sweep in an upward and outward directions starting on the cheek area. This is to remove dead cells and remnant dirt away from the skin, so try not to press into the skin. Then move to the forehead. The hydrating ingredients also serve as glue on the cotton pad to effectively remove dirt remnants without stripping skin's own water. And move to the chin and neck areas. Step 3. Follow up with the patting method we have learned just now. So instead of buying two products, Hada Labo lotion alone is enough.
Welcome back, guys, to our Be Skin Smart program. And for our last segment today, Valerie will then address some of the questions that we got off the Facebook page. Thank you all the questions, but unfortunately, we will not have time to answer all of them now. But fret not, because Valerie will be answering them right after the program. So first up, what is the purpose for the Super Hyaluronic Acid Hydrating Lotion, or what I call Super HA Hydrating Lotion?
Hada Labo Super HA Hydrating Lotion contains three types of hyaluronic acids, or HA. Now, HA is a natural skin component that is found in our skin, and it helps to absorb water to keep the skin moist. The lotion contains three types of HA that target every skin layer. The HA absorbs 6 times water its weight, replenishes skin's top layer with instant hydration for smooth, refined skin. The Super HA, 2 times more moisture than HA, locks moisture in the skin's middle layer for supple bounciness. And the Nano HA, smallest of all, goes deepest of skin bottom layer to store moisture for clear radiance that shines from within. The lotion acts hydration to make skin soft, smooth and bouncy, but also acts as an essence booster to activate skin's absorption power. You can also use it as a double cleanser with cotton pad as well. Lovely all-in-one, very innovative product, as what you would expect from a Japanese brand. When using the Hada Labo Super HA Hydrating Lotion, complement it with our patting technique. Patting and tapping technique for the night, it helps to activate and accelerate penetration in the skin.
Wow, that's a lot of helpful tips and information over there. So, second question, is Hada Labo Lotion a toner?
Hada Labo Lotion functions more than just a toner. Traditional cotton wipe-away toner strip the skin's own natural water and give drying effect, and can disrupt or damage skin's natural barrier. First, Hada Labo lotions can be used for double cleansing with a cotton pad. The hydrating ingredients act as a glue with the cotton pad to effectively remove dirt remnants without stripping skin's own water. Secondly, it introduces hydration into the skin, which is what Asian skin needs most. Thirdly, it activates skin's moisture locking ability so that it acts as an essence booster as well.
Okay, great. Last question. What's the difference between the hydrating lotion and the light hydrating lotion?
The main difference between these two lotions is the texture. For people with oily combination skin, they may prefer a lighter texture, hence the Super HA Light Hydrating Lotion would be more suitable. For those with dry or normal skin, they would generally prefer the Super HA Hydrating Lotion. Also, for ladies who are in a rush in the morning, they can choose to use the Light Hydrating Lotion, and at night, they can choose the regular lotion. It's important to remember that Asian skin needs lots of hydration. Basically, the product function, benefits, and usage for both are the same.
So thank you, Valerie, and this has been a very informative episode with you. So thank you all for staying with us, and tune in to our next episode for more Skin Smart tips and tricks. on how to achieve good and beautiful skin. Bye!
ただにいいことはだラボ。